Welcome to the program. Now, it is surprise and surprise in the Democratic Republic of Congo, DRC. Seven opposition leaders on Sunday picked little-known lawmaker Martin Fayulu as their joint candidate for the country's long-delayed presidential elections, which would be held, which will take place in December. The opposition leaders' meeting in the Swiss city of Geneva, in fact, included two top figures, Jean-Pierre Bemba and ex-provincial governor Moise Katumbi. But both have been barred from standing in the election. So who is Martin Fayulu and what led to his emergence as the opposition's joint candidate? Nyasha Mutiswa and Brice Kinu tell us more in this report.
After 3 days of intense negotiations in Geneva, Switzerland, with the facilitation of Kofi Annan Foundation, the seven opposition leaders in the Democratic Republic of Congo, DRC, on Sunday nominated MP Martin Fayulu as the only opposition candidate in the December presidential election who could be the successor to Joseph Kabila, who has been in power for 18 years. In the DRC, the results of this meeting were eagerly awaited, especially by those who want a changeover of the head of state. In order to bring this political struggle to a successful conclusion, the Lamuka coalition voted to select Martin Fayulu Madidi as the common candidate for the presidential election on 23 December 2018. Fayulu, who will turn 62 on November 21, is the president of the opposition party, Commitment for Citizenship and Development. His appointment, greeted by applause and shouts of joy from some of the Congolese present, surprised because Felix Tshisekedi, president of the historic opposition party, UDPS, seemed to be the likely candidate. In a joint statement signed by the seven participants, the coalition pledged to, quote, put an end to the current political crisis and stop the general deterioration of the country.
Well, our DRC correspondent Patrice Terry is joining us with more details on this subject. Good morning to you, Patrice. Well, it appears most people don't know Martin Fayulu. Can you tell us more about him? Martin Fadidi Fayulu was born on 21st November 1956 in Kinshasa. He is a Congolese businessman and also a national deputy president of the opposition party Commitment for Citizenship and Development, and currently the presidential candidate elect. He attended the University of Paris 12, where he obtained a master's degree in general economics, and also attended the European University of America in San Francisco, California, where he obtained his master's in business administration. He joined the Mobil Oil Group in Kinshasa in September 1984 and ended his career in the group in 2003 as managing director of ExxonMobil Ethiopia after having held various positions at the company's headquarters in the USA. He was also the African headquarters. He was also in the African headquarters in Paris and other affiliates in Africa, including Ivory Coast, Kenya, Nigeria, and Mali. In 1990, he was president of the political movement called the Forum for Democracy and Development, which he was a member of the Sacred Union of the Opposition. In 1991, he participated in the Sovereign National Conference, where he was vice chairman of the Economic Industry and SME Commission. In 1993, he was elected by his peers of the CNS as a member of the High Council of the Republic Transitional Parliament, elected in 2006. He doubled as provincial deputy of the city of Kinshasa and national deputy. He chose to sit in Kinshasa Provincial Assembly, leaving his mandate.
Emmanuel Chadari a été choisi par la majorité présidentielle.
Well, a few months ago, the choice of Emmanuel Chadari by the presidential clan created a surprise in DRC. Is Martin Fayulu also a surprise candidate? Indeed. Majority of the people expected Félix to be appointed, but considering sociological realities, Congolese card, so far many ethnic groups are scared to elect a person of ethnical or tribal origin to a UDPS presidential position. Even the late Etienne, that's Félix's father, never won the majority in the opposition like Fayulu today. However, the other ethnic groups fear that once the IPOD leader is in power, the others will have nothing to say about the affairs of the country. The appointment of Martin Fayulu, I believe, satisfies national opinion. Opposition leaders have also been advised at a recent opposition party meeting to stop betraying the people. They are much more directed to Vital Kemehi, as well as other opposition personalities, not to betray. This is simply because many members of the opposition joined the camp of outgoing President Joseph Kabila. Just to get ministerial appointment.
Changer de camp entre les camps du président Joseph Kabila et l'opposition, et on lui insistait de ne pas trahir la population. Et c'est tout simplement parce que beaucoup de membres de l'opposition ont rejoint le camp du président Kabila aujourd'hui, et ils sont au gouvernement et à la coalition présidentielle.
Merci, Patrice.
Well, thank you very much, Patrice, for your time this morning.
Je vous en prie.
Voilà, right, that was Patrice Terry there, our correspondent in Kinshasa, highlighting Martin Fayulu's profile, opposition presidential candidate select for the December elections.
Many thanks indeed, Patrice. And are you surprised by that, Barbara, by the decision to the choice of Martin Fayulu?
C'est sûr que personne ne s'attendait à lui.
Well, we'll wait to see exactly how the election will turn out. It's billed for December. Right. So you're watching The Morning Call right here on African News. We have more stories making the headlines from across different parts of the continent. Up next in the African Journal.